will introduce to you a model of 5 C's, which is an evidence-based model for good consultation. Consultations generally have 2 benefits. First is the benefit of to the patient. You need an answer from your colleague about specific question. Sometimes we need a specific request or applying a certain maneuver to the patient. This is the first benefit from consultation. The second is learning. Through consultation, good consultation, we can learn the related updates in other specialties. We commonly need consultation in neurosurgery, like anesthesia for preoperative evaluation, pediatrics, orthopedics, vascular surgery, and multiple trauma patients, and so on. During hospital admission, during ICU admission, during ICU transfer, during transfer of care, during a request of co-management, you may consult internal medicine doctors for diabetic hypertensive patients, cardiac patients, and so on. You may request for an opinion. You may need the opinion of clinical pharmacy in prescribing certain drugs, their service request, imaging, neurophysiological study. You may need consultation for procedure request. Some neurosurgeons do not have time for lumbar puncture. They may request anesthesia for making the lumbar puncture. It's a procedure request. So the first C is contact. You have to contact your colleague in a way that put him in the context of your consultation. You have to contact in the way that engage them in your work to know what you need exactly. An urgent request, you have to say, dear colleague, it's an urgent request. It's an emergency. In another situation, it may be appropriate to say, dear doctor, great pleasure to share with you the management of this patient, or good day, doctor, and so on. Contact is very important for icebreaking and for engaging your colleague appropriately in patient problem. The second C is a story, concise story. This is for communication. You have to introduce the problem before asking your request or your specific question. So it is fine to provide short story, starting with a prefix for the patient name, then the patient name, age, sex, short, concise story of the manifestations, diagnoses, and procedures done, and any complications happen, to communicate with your colleague before providing the specific question. The third C is core question or core request. You are consulting a cardiologist who prescribed antihypertensive drugs for a patient with cerebrovascular insufficiency and you are afraid from dehydration. So your specific question after providing the story of the patient, is it necessary to give diuretics for this patient? The fourth C is the collaboration. We mean to express the plan, your plan, and the consequences of the opinion of your colleague. You have to engage them in the plan. Let them know the impact of their opinion or of their decision on your plan of management. Provide clear explanation of your plan of management. I'm planning for conservative treatment, but if there is so-and-so, I may change the opinion for surgical decompression. Express that the surgery is risky, but avoiding surgery means that the patient may be bedbound for a longer time, requiring anticoagulation, which has negative impact on the patient diagnosis, and so on. This may affect the decision of the anesthesia when they know your plan and get engaged in the patient condition. The fifth C, which is very important, is closing the loop. You may be available for telephone communication during the consultation, during your colleague visit. You may be available for in-person communication during consultation. Usually when I consult physiotherapy, I ask them for a report after completing the program for 3 months or 6 months and so on, explaining and clarifying the plan of physiotherapy and what has been applied and what is expected and what has been achieved for collaboration and communication, and this is part of closing the loop. You may ask your colleagues to write down their recommendations and let them know that you will contact them after revising their opinion or recommendation and so on. So these are the 5 C's of good consultation. I encourage you to apply this type of consultation, good consultation, with the 5 C's many, many times until it becomes a habit. And always remember, the aim of consultation is not only to benefit the patient, it's an important part of consultation, but also an important tool of teaching and learning. Let your colleagues know that their comprehensive explanation is welcome. This will open a window for you for exposure to the updates in the other specialties. Wish you sound and fruitful practice, and thank you for your attention.